Hey everyone, All Natural Angela here. Today is Canada Day and I decided that I was going to do a recipe. Since it's the beginning of summer, we're going to do a recipe for a homemade bug spray. And at the end of this video, there will also be a small giveaway. So you want to stay tuned to the end and I'll have that little surprise for you. So this recipe is for an 8-ounce bottle, but I only have a 4-ounce bottle with me today, so I'm going to cut the recipe in half. This is a recipe that about a month ago, a friend of mine asked if I could make a bug spray because she was going camping. And the whole family used the bug spray and really loved it, except for the youngest son who still got bitten all over by mosquitoes. So, it was good for everyone but him. This is a really simple recipe. And again, it's for an 8-ounce bottle, but I'm going to do a 4-ounce bottle. So it calls for 30 drops of geranium, 30 drops of citronella oil, 20 drops of lemon eucalyptus, 20 drops of lavender, 10 drops of rosemary, a tablespoon of vodka or rubbing alcohol, a half a cup of witch hazel, a half a cup of water or vinegar, and a teaspoon of vegetable glycerin. So, again, I'm going to cut the recipe in half. So what I'm going to start with, I'm just going to start working my way down with the oils. So, I have my geranium. I'm going to do 15 drops. And of course you can't see this. Which is very flowery smelling. And it calls for citronella, but I don't have that, so and lemongrass is a really good substitute, so I'll do my lemongrass next. So 15 drops of lemongrass. Smells really nice. And if you get an extra drop in there, don't worry about it. So now we're going to do 10 drops of eucalyptus. It says lemon eucalyptus, but I just have regular eucalyptus. So we're going to do 10 drops. And I will post this recipe in the comments afterwards. And it calls for 10 drops of lavender. And again, I'll apologize for my snuffing. I am still sick. And 5 drops of rosemary. Essential oils in the bottle. You can maybe see them there. So next is a tablespoon. So we're going to use half of that. So half a tablespoon. I have some measuring cups here. I have my handy dandy measuring cups that I just keep with my supplies. I only use these things for my essential oils and my mixes and potions. So half a tablespoon of vodka or rubbing alcohol. And I'm going to use rubbing alcohol today. When I made this for my friend, actually used vodka. And I did not bring a funnel with me, so this is going to be interesting. Oh, not going to make too much of a mess here. Good, good. Only a little bit of mess, so let's grab some paper towel. We'll just put that right under the bottle. Maybe if I poured straight from the bottle, it would have been easier. Just another little dab in there. Alright, so a half a cup of witch hazel, so we're going to go with a quarter of a cup. Here. So where is my quarter of a cup? Right here. So I'm just gonna squeeze this into the cup. And you will find witch hazel is used in a lot of recipes. It makes a great Alright, so I pause that for a second because as much as I like to make a mess, I want to go downstairs and get a funnel. So I'm going to pour in the witch hazel, which is a lot easier with a funnel. No mess. The next thing is also a quarter cup of water or vinegar. I have distilled water. It's very cheap. It's about $1.50 a jug. The only thing I use it for is my recipe, so it'll probably last forever. And we're going to get that into the bottle without making a mess. Alrighty. And the last thing we need is a teaspoon of vegetable glycerin. Which I bought. Oh, there goes the cat. I bought this at a local soap store. It's actually by New Directions Aromatics, which is another company that sells essential oils. So, I have not used this one yet, so we're just going to pop the little safety seal off the top here. It says 1 teaspoon, so we only really need half a teaspoon, and lucky for me, I have a half teaspoon here. Oh, and that's too much, but that's okay. There we go. Got that in. So far so good. I'm just going to put those over there. And start putting caps on things before I start making a big mess. Because nobody needs vegetable glycerin all over the table. Alright, so, here we go. Our bottle is filled right at the top. It's kind of milky looking. And we're going to screw the cap on tight, give it a shake, and there we go. We have bug spray. Can be used all over, can be used for children. I wouldn't use it on babies. I would probably dilute it more if I was going to use it on smaller children. But you're, 8, 9, 10 year olds. Works perfect for, again, except for my friend's son. So now, the other thing that I made for her, and her son actually loved because he got covered in bug bites, I made an afterbite roll-on for him. And I made it in a 10mm rollerball like this. It just comes with a little rollerball on the top and the cover. And I mixed it up for him, and he loved it. She said that just using it on him, she used up over half of the bottle while they were gone for the week. Because he loved it so much, it made his bites, it just took away all the pain and the itch. So, for those who stayed to the end, if you want the afterbite recipe, you're going to have to send me a message, make a note in the comments, and I will send you a link to the recipe for the afterbite. I just want to thank everyone for watching. It's All Natural Angela. You can find me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and YouTube at All Natural Angela. If you have any questions, any comments, want to know more about the essential oils that I use, please post and I will answer. Thank you so much and have a great day.